Hi everyone! During previous months, I did couple of watercolor backgrounds and I made them using granulating watercolors. One of the followers asked me to explain what does it mean and my thoughts about using this medium for coloring. The most famous manufacturer of granulating watercolors is Daniel Smith. They have amazing professional watercolors, huge range of colors. I have only a couple of them. I have Cascade Green, Undersea Green, Moon Glow and Lunar Blue. They all are granulating. Granulation means that when you apply watercolors to the paper, you get very beautiful and artistic stains or color will divide into another colors, like I have here this green watercolor on the paper created beautiful blue and golden stains. So pigments which created this watercolor started to divide on the paper. Perhaps Moon Glow is the most famous product of Daniel Smith. It has a very interesting color. When you apply it, it's almost dull gray, but then you can clearly see dark purple, dark pink, gray, or dark blue areas. There is a cheaper version of granulating watercolors. It is produced by Royal Talents company under the brand of Royal Talents, but they made only 5 colors so far and they are less interesting. Let me show you a couple of examples where I already managed to use granulating watercolors. Here is my search of the light bulb Bogler book. And I created this smoke with Moon Glow. It was quite nice. I simply colored this smoke with one watercolor and it created beautiful stains of pink and gray. This color is also a nice match to color of Derwent graphitint pencils. And if you are interested, I have this coloring video on my channel. Next background with granulating watercolors I did in Escape to Oz book, and here I used a little bit of Lunar Blue, but mostly again Moon Glow. I decided for myself that I quite like Moon Glow and Lunar Blue to do backgrounds for Halloween pictures, for some sinister scenes, but it was a page where I realized that working with granulating watercolors isn't very easy. It's not very easy to learn how to do medium. And the last background which I want to show is page which I colored during October. Here I used a Royal Talent dusk pink color. Just from one watercolor, I was able to get those interesting stains from pink, magenta, violet and dark gray. Again, this process is available on my channel. In Daniel Smith's line, they have a lot of very interesting granulating colors and I definitely think that I prefer granulating watercolors when paint divides into several colors apart from black. Like in Moon Glow we have pink, violet, gray, even dark blue. In Cascade Green we have blue, green, golden and different shades of green. Apart from those multi-pigment granulating watercolors, Daniel Smith also have amazing line of Primatech watercolors, which are made from genuine minerals, and mostly they have granulation of color pigment and black. Here is the full line of Daniel Smith watercolors. Color range is amazing, and in the line there is a lot of granulated paint, both in the main collection and in Prime Attack collection. But the only problem is that the price of Daniel Smith is quite high. So I wouldn't recommend to purchase many of granulating watercolors before you actually tested at least one of them in coloring books. Granulating watercolors from Royal Talents are much more simpler. They have color pigment and black oxide. So granulation is only color plus black stains. Still, they are able to create interesting effects. Maybe they are not very versatile, but at least for some backgrounds, they are not bad. When I got my first tubes of Daniel Smith granulating watercolors, I was quite eager to start using them for backgrounds, but immediately I realized that they behave not as so as I expected them. I realized that they are not very easy to use, at least for me. I realized that the main reason of my struggle, of all my problems, is paper quality. Daniel Smith granulating watercolors are intended for professional watercoloring, watercolor painting on watercolor paper with some texture, and we work in coloring books in quite smooth and plain paper. I decided to make a quick test. Here in the upper part I have a sketchbook with paper which is quite similar to the paper in Hanna Carlson book. And in the lower part I have a sheet of watercolor paper with quite a nice texture. On the average smooth paper, granulating watercolor starts to gather in puddles. So there is a risk to have not very unpleasant stains and not very prominent granulating effect. On the rough watercolor paper, pigment of granulating watercolor spreads much better, and it pigment clings to the texture of paper. Granulating effect is much more visible and it starts immediately. So on the thinner and smoother paper, like we have in coloring books, I have constantly to push pigment from those puddles, to push water, to add additional pigment, and it's much more difficult to get beautiful stains without rough edges and with visible granulating effect. So here on the textured paper, paints behave much more predictable and much better. But it's not as easy. When granulating watercolors dries, just like regular watercolors, they became less intense, they became paler. And it was a surprise that on smoother paper color remains brighter, so pigment wasn't absorbed into the surface of the paper. And on watercolor paper you can see that colors are much duller. I was quite surprised. I wasn't expecting it. 1 point goes to watercolor paper for granulating effect, and 1 point goes to regular paper for brightness of colors. By the way, in the upper part here I have Cascade Green, Moon Glow, and Royal Talents Dusk Pink. Okay, next I decided that I want to test them on wet surface. I quite often wet paper in coloring books, especially for backgrounds in Hanna Carlson. I use regular watercolors and I
Love this effect for getting beautiful stains and interesting color transitions. And again, here I was quite surprised. In the upper part, I have immediate problem with this big puddle of water. Everything is gathered in one place where paper is slightly bended from the water. Pigment is gathered here. So I predict that there I will have this granulating effect, but it doesn't look very attractive here. Again, I need to constantly correct it, to push it with my brush. A lot of work and not very easy medium. In the bottom part, I don't have such problems because paper is slightly thicker, so it doesn't bend and pigment spreads better. But after granulating watercolors dried completely, again I got a surprise. Stains looked better on the bottom sample, but the watercolor paper absorbed color pigment almost completely, so I got quite dark, almost gray and black stain without quite bright stains of pink. In the upper part on the smooth paper, you can see this bright magenta pink. Not very beautiful form of stains, but color is quite interesting. So regular paper better preserves brightness of color, but sometimes form of stains isn't very interesting, especially if you add too much water. At this moment I realized that the final effect of granulating watercolors highly depends from paper quality. You can work with them on watercolor paper with a rough surface. You can work with them on smooth paper like we have in coloring books, but you need to use different techniques, different amount of water, of pigment, and to control and to move pigment. So, as I said, they are not very easy to learn. From my opinion, you will need a lot of practice before you will get the desired effect, desired brightness, and desired form of stains. I call them slightly capricious paints, and they definitely won't work nice on very thin paper. Definitely not. But you will have a lot of fun in process. For me, it was some kind of chemistry, of alchemy, especially when I started to do mixes. Here is another test when I tried to add to regular watercolors from White Nights brand and from Ukrainian manufacturer Rosa, just to my regular sets of watercolors, pigment of oxide black. When Royal Talents company manufactured their line of dusk colors, dusk pink, dusk yellow, dusk green and dusk violet, which are available now, they simply mixed pigment, color pigment, with this oxide black. So I purchased oxide black paint individually and I tried to mix it with different colors. Sometimes I got quite ugly mix, sometimes effect was quite interesting. I especially loved mixes of oxide black with ultramarine, with cobalt and with various shades of green. I definitely will be using those mixes if I need to create those dark and rich backgrounds. I also tried to mix various granulating watercolors, which I own, with golden watercolors, especially from Kuretake Zig set. And it was quite interesting. I really love effect. You know that when we add water to golden watercolors from Kuretake Zig, or to pearl watercolors by Fintech, you can see those parts of pearl pigment floating, and together with granulating pigment in those watercolors, they mix really nice. I think that I definitely will dedicate another video to all mixes which I was able to create mixing cure takizik golden watercolors and granulating watercolors by Daniel Smith and Royal Talents. So during my process of testing them and for using them for actual coloring, I have some interesting moments. I really enjoyed mixing them, and I also have some problems, some falls, some defeats. I can't say that I managed to learn them perfectly. I definitely will continue trying to mix them to learn them better. And for now, I don't think that I need to invest more money into purchasing other Daniel Smith colors apart from those which I already own. Of course, I have in my wish list couple of interesting Daniel Smith paint, but I definitely will wait until I get a better understanding of these granulating paints. Now I want to show you a couple of interesting mixes which I managed to do. Here I added a little bit of orange into Lunar Blue Daniel Smith, and I think that it's quite beautiful effect. You can see granulating in the area where blue is connected with orange. Color transition is beautiful, and I really enjoy to look at how pigment spreads. This is a nice mix, and I definitely will be using it for some of the backgrounds. This is when pigment starts to dry and granulating effect become more prominent, more visible. Other beautiful mixes I got when I mixed Moon Glow with Indigo or with Lunar Blue. This mix of dark colors I really like. I noted it for myself, and I definitely will be using it for my future colorings. Another reason why I decided to film this video is because of the line of granulating watercolors from Royal Talents. Line is quite small, only 4 paints, but prices are much more affordable, and I think that they are available just like in my country, in Russia, and also in Europe. So maybe it will be easier for people to get at least 1 or 2 colors and to test them, not investing too much money in Daniel Smith paints. Here I mixed simple violet watercolor by White Nights with dusk pink by Royal Talents in the upper part, and with Moon Glow by Daniel Smith in the bottom part, and both mixes are quite nice. Again, I consider it as a successful mix and another mix which I definitely will be using in coloring. Another mix which I really like a lot is regular cobalt turquoise paint mixed with Moon Glow in the upper part and with Lunar Blue in the bottom part. All regular blue colors from my watercolor palette, like ultramarine, cobalt blue, ultramarine violet, indigo, created interesting mixes with granulating watercolors, but cobalt turquoise was definitely the best. Royal Talents informs that we can mix their dusk colors and also create new interesting shades. As I don't own all of their paints, I posted for you pictures from their official site to show which mixes you can get from their 4 dusk paints. So, in conclusion, I can say that granulating watercolors are quite interesting. There are some beautiful shades. My favorite Daniel Smith paints are Moon Glow, Undersea Green, Cascade Green, and Lunar Blue. Here I demonstrate you another mixes which I tried to create. Royal Talents paints are maybe not as interesting as Daniel Smith's, but for their price they are not bad and also definitely worth to try. They all are quite demanding to the paper and you will need some time to adjust to them to learn how much water to add, how much pigment to add, how to wetten surface and how to move pigment, how many layers to add. But I'm sure that in the process you will have a lot of fun. So if you're interested in creating watercolors background, you may consider adding granulating watercolors to your coloring stash. Don't expect immediate miracles, but I think that they are worth to try and worth to learn working with. Sorry if it wasn't very instructive. As I said, I have some positive moments from these paints and also some defeats, and I'm still in the process of learning them. I thank you for watching and I hope to show you in the future more colorings with these interesting paints.